Welcome to the spoken tutorial on abstract classes. In this tutorial, we will learn about abstract methods and concrete methods, abstract classes and concrete classes, and how to use abstract classes. For this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu 12.04, JDK 1.7, and Eclipse 4.3.1. To follow this tutorial, you should have knowledge of basics of Java and Eclipse IDE. You should also have the knowledge of subclassing in Java. If not, for relevant Java tutorials, please visit the link shown. First, we will see about abstract method. An abstract method is a method that is declared without implementation. It is declared using abstract keyword. There should not be opening and closing parentheses for this method. The method show details illustrated here is an example of abstract method. Note that this method is declared using the abstract keyword with no current implementation. Next, we will see about concrete method. A concrete method is completely implemented within the curly brackets. This method show basic details illustrated here is an example of concrete method. Observe that this method is implemented completely. Now we will learn about abstract class with an example. An abstract class usually contains at least one abstract method. Abstract methods can be added only to abstract classes. The class person illustrated here is an abstract class. It contains an abstract method called showDetails. It can also contain variables and other concrete methods. The figure here represents an inheritance relation. Here, the person class is an abstract class. The employee class and the student class are subclasses of the person class. These subclasses can provide their own different implementations. These are done by showDetails method present in the person class. For example, showDetails method in the employee class prints the employee ID and the salary, whereas showDetails method in the student class prints the student register number and grade. A class is said to be a concrete class if all the methods in that class are concrete methods. The class employee illustrated here is a concrete class. All the methods inside this class, including showDetails, are concrete. Let us understand the usage of abstract class with a sample program. Now we will switch to Eclipse and create a new project called Abstract Demo. Inside this project, we will create the necessary classes to demonstrate the usage of abstract class. Now, right-click on SRC folder and click New Class. Type the name of the class as Person and press Enter. Now, we will add the fields to represent the name and the age of the person. Type String Name semicolon. Also type Int Age semicolon. Now click on Source and select Generate Constructor using Fields. Delete the super keyword from the generated code. The constructor can initialize the values of name and age fields. We will add a concrete method to this class to print the name and age. So type public void show basic details. Within brackets, type system.out.println, within round brackets, and within quotes, type name colon plus name semicolon. Also type system.out.println within round brackets and within quotes age colon plus age semicolon. Now we will add an abstract method to this class. So type public void showDetails semicolon. An error comes up since we have not yet added the abstract keyword. So now add the keyword abstract. Now we can see another error comes up. This is because abstract methods can be added only to abstract classes. So now add the keyword abstract to the person class to make it an abstract class. Then right-click on the default package and create another class called employee. Now to make this class a subclass of person class, type extends person. Now we can see an error comes up in the Eclipse IDE. It indicates that we should provide an implementation to the abstract method showDetails. We will do it a little later. Now create two fields to represent the employee ID and employee salary. So type string empid semicolon and int salary semicolon. Now click on source and then select generate constructor using fields. This constructor can initialize the values of name, age, empid and salary. Let us now define the showDetails method. So type public void showDetails. Inside this method, we need to print the employee details. So type system.out.println within quotes empid colon plus empid semicolon. System.out.println within quotes salary colon plus salary semicolon. Note that the error disappears once the showDetails method is implemented. Next, we will see a student class of the project. I have already created a subclass called student. There are two fields in the student class, register number and grade, which represent student register number and grade. A constructor is also created inside this class. This constructor can be used to initialize the values for name, age, register number, and grade. The showDetails method is also implemented in this class. It prints the values of student register number and grade. Now note that the employee class has its own implementation of showDetails. And the student class has its own implementation of showDetails. Now right-click on the default package, click on New Class and then type name as demo. Inside this class, we will have the main method. So type main and then press Ctrl space to generate the main method. Now let us try to instantiate the person class by typing person P equals new person. Within brackets and double quotes, type John and put a semicolon. Now we can see an error. This is because the person class is abstract and it cannot be instantiated. Let's remove this line. Type the following code as displayed on the screen. Now let us instantiate the person class using the employee class as person P1 equals new employee. In the first line, we are passing the values of different arguments. John is passed as employee name, 40 as the value of age, E267 as the value of employee ID, and 10,000 as the value of employee salary. Now we can invoke the concrete method in the person class as p1.showBasicDetails. We can also call the showDetails method using the object p1 as p1.showDetails. Similarly, instantiate the person class using the student class. This is represented as person P2 equals new student. Now, we are passing the values of different arguments. Hari is passed as the value of student name, 20 as the value of age, 12005 as the value of student register number, and A as the value of grade. Now we can call the showBasicDetails method using the object P2 as p2.showBasicDetails. We can also invoke the showDetails method using the object p2 as p2.showDetails. Now let us run this demo program. So right-click on the class demo and then select Run as Java application. We can see the output with the basic employee details like name and age. These are printed by showBasicDetails method. Other employee details like employee ID and salary are printed by the showDetails method. Similarly, the basic student details like name and age are printed by showBasicDetails method. Other details of the student like student register number and grade are printed by the showDetails method. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we have learnt about abstract methods and concrete methods, abstract classes and concrete classes, and how to create and use abstract classes. As an assignment, create an abstract class vehicle which contains an abstract method run. Create a subclass car which extends the vehicle class and implements the run method that prints car is running on four wheels. Also create a subclass bike which again extends the vehicle class and implements the run method that prints bike is running on two wheels. Also create a demo class containing the main method to verify the results. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials and gives certificates on passing the online test. For more details, please write to us. Spoken tutorial project is funded by NMEICT MHRD Government of India. More information on this mission is available at the link shown. This script has been contributed by Department of Information Technology, Amal Jyoti College of Engineering. This is Priya from IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for joining.